एसचान प्रेजेंट्स एजुकेशनल वीडियो लेक्चर्स एज पर द AICTE करिकुलम डिफिकल्ट कॉन्सेप्ट्स मेड इजी स्टडी एनीवेयर एनीटाइम।
सो नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज आर थ्री फेजर ऑफ एसी सर्किट। बेसिकली दैट इज यूज्ड इन ऑल ऑफ द कॉन्फिगरेशंस like in the transformer and all that. So three phasor AC circuit is used in this case. I am Narinder Kaur. Now if you want to study all these topics in details, so you can refer this book from S. Chand Publishing. Link is also given in the description box. Now I will explain the three phasor AC circuit, then their configuration like star and delta combination. So first is a three phasor AC circuit. Three phasor AC circuit. Now, in this case, three powers are used. First one, that is a I1, I0, sin omega t. Second one is a I2, that is equals to I0, sin omega t plus 120, and the third one is the I3, which is I0 sin omega t minus 120. That means in this case the three inputs are present over here. One is the I0 sin omega t, second one, you can clearly see that there is a phase difference between these three two with an angle of 120. Now when we represent over here, you can clearly see that if this is I1, here if this is a I1, now I2, the phase difference between I1 and I2 is 120, so that will be the I2. Again the phase difference is again 120, so this is the I3. Here the angle between these two is 120 degree. Again this is 120. So this is called three phasor diagram. In three phasor diagram, three inputs are present over here with the phase difference angle of 120 degree with each other. So in this case, if this is represented with yellow color Y and that is represented with red color R and it is represented with blue color, we know that in the power supply wires, you can see that there the three wires are present over here. One is with the yellow color, second one is with the red color, and third one is with the blue color. So one is earth in that case. Now again, we know that when in the wire combination, if the connection of this R and B, that is interchanged, when these connections are interchanged on the speed of the coil, that is not affected. But when you see that in this case, when this combination is altered over here, the direction of movement is changed. So that is important over here. So when in our household suppliers, when the wires are combined with each other, the red part is connected with the red part, blue is connected with the blue part, while the yellow part is connected with the yellow part, because it will represent the direction of movement. The direction of movement is clockwise. Here it is anti-clockwise or clockwise. It will depend ki how you combine this R that is red, blue and white, yellow combination. Now in the again on the phasor diagram, how you can represent this? So phasor diagram, if this is a yellow one with no phase difference, then this is a blue one again this is a red one. So these are the phasor diagram for three wires or the three power supplies which are represented in the three phasor circuit. Now again combining these three two, there are two combinations are present. One is a star configuration and delta configuration. In the part one, I have explained you about the three phasor diagram and how the three inputs are connected with each other, and about and also their output is calculated and the three phasor diagram is plotted. Now in this upcoming part, in this part I will explain you about the star and the delta configuration. So in the star and the delta configuration, how the resistance are present and calculated their output voltage and the current values. Now if you want to study all these topics in details, so you can refer this book from S. Chand Publishing. Link is also given in the description box. Now if you like the video, please like, share and subscribe the S. Chand Academy and also press the bell icon for the future notifications. Thank you.
All rights reserved. This video has been prepared for educational purposes only. No part of it may be reproduced or copied without the permission of the copyright holder.